Joslin, who's come from America. He's the founder and inventor of Indoboard. He's surfer, skater, been around for years, knows his stuff. And here we are today. Started to say in America, we've got it into Europe now, in England, doing classes, doing big classes in America, so it's all pretty good. He's going to take it away and we're going to help out and we're going to just go through some bits and bobs, and what we'll do is we'll then probably just hit mill through it stuff, and then we'll do some advanced stuff as well as we go along, sort of thing. Alright? So enjoy.
Hello. First, I'll just let you know I'm not a trainer. I'm a surfer. So we'll try to get through this in a training sort of way. First thing we want to do is we're going to put the board on the cushion. So pick your board up. You can see the middle of the board, the widest point, and wrap your fingers underneath. And you look down at the cushion, and obviously that's going to be the widest point. So the object of this exercise is to just get the board to lay perfectly flat on the cushion. All right, so you're going to go down and feel the cushion with your fingers and position it so it lays flat. If it tilts to one side, you just have to move it just a slight bit. That's it. So then we're going to start with our addressing the board with our feet shoulder width apart. So make sure you're not too narrow, because the first thing is people think their shoulders are like that. I mean, I like to think my shoulders are a bit wider. So you want shoulder width apart, you're going to put your first foot on the deck, looking down to make sure that you have the same distance from your toe to the toe edge and your heel to the heel edge, so that you're in the center. Put all your weight on the first foot, look down, place your second foot, make sure that you're equidistant to the ends as well. The rules are no arms, no movement of the head and shoulders. It all comes from your core and your legs. And if you fight it like this young lady over here, it becomes much more difficult. Don't fight, your knees must be bent slightly. So we're going to change a little bit from the typical workout stance, which most people are trained to be in here. We're going to do something that we call the war rider stance, which is your shoulders over your hips, which are over your ankles, which requires you to have a slight tummy tuck forward to bring your hips right underneath your shoulder. What this does in the training vernacular, this creates what is known as a neutral spine, so that you can move your spine around. So if we had some good boogie-woogie music, we can boogie-woogie all day long. The second rule, besides no arms, no movement of the shoulders, if you feel any tension or pulling in your Achilles tendon, you are going the wrong direction. You must always feel the pressure generally under the balls of your feet. Okay, and that will keep, and the purpose of what we're trying to do here is keep the board flat. And you hear all those clicks? The object of the proposition is to not touch the ground. Remember, your shoulders need to be back over your hips. Our young lady over there, push your hips slightly to the front. If you look from the side, if I stand like this, I'm just going to tuck my hips forward. I'm exaggerating so that you see that movement. And that's what you're trying to do. That's it. Much better. Board riding stance, a neutral spine, that gives us mobility and be able to flex. So let's go heel to toe, without wobbling if we can. Just to feel like that. That is a slow boy motion. Now, we're going to make it a little more difficult. We're going to get into a good, strong, athletic stance. From here, rotate your hips back and down about 5 inches. And see if you can hold that for about 20 seconds. All right, let's go down one more time. Nice. About 5 to 6 inches. Hold that. Keep your head and shoulders back. Remember, posture. What we're working on here is posture and core strength equals balance. Hold that nice and steady. Okay. Come on up. How's that feel?